of a thing. Kevin, it's your buddy Sam Rubin in LA. How are you?
How are you, man? How you doing?
Very good. Where did you just come from?
I just actually flew from LA. I'm in New York now. I have to go Saratoga, New York, then Atlantic City, New Jersey. I got shows this weekend. So I was in LA taping my show TKO yesterday. Then I flew here today, and I'm with my partners and amazing friends at Raleigh. We're doing some good things today. Good deeds.
Good deeds, good tasks, good motives. All that. You know, but Kevin, you and I have talked about this before. I'm always astounded and impressed by the capacity of Kevin Hart. Are you doing just more? Is it 26 hours of work in a 24-hour day every day?
36. 36 hours of work in a 24-hour day.
And do you ever tire of it?
Absolutely. But I wouldn't have it any other way. I'm completely okay with it at the level that it's at.
And then here's the thing. This Entrepreneur Magazine article I read, it's really, and you talk about the importance of ownership and how you made decisions that other comics would never have even thought to have made. What made the light bulb go on? We're looking at you holding a light bulb on the cover of the magazine.
You know what? Separation. Looking at a pack and figuring out ways to put yourself outside the pack. Not being the same. Being different, but at the same time, trying to figure out ways to be a groundbreaker. And shape and mold and manipulate the entertainment business into being what you want it to be. And there was a time in my career where I didn't have that definition. As I got older, as I got more mature, and I started to, I guess you could say, really learn the business and look at it through a different lens, I got to see that being self-creative is the best kind of creative that you can be. Because when you are, and you do have a level of ammunition that's just about creating and expanding and exploring, you're not afraid anymore. You're not afraid to hear the word no. You're really ambitious. So the word no motivates you more. That's when I said I can be for myself, by myself, create more for myself. And as I do, the opportunities for myself will grow. And then I can create opportunities for others. I can't do nothing for anybody if I don't do nothing for me first.
But first and foremost, because I think of this as your brand, is funny above all, or should it be above all?
For me, absolutely. I mean, funny is what, that's my door. You know, funny opened up the door to everything else for me. Even when you talk about physical fitness and my level of involvement with health and wellness, I mean, funny is what got me there. Being on the road and being funny is when I discovered, oh my God, I'm not taking care of myself. Funny is what got me into the business world that I'm in. My business mind is now far developed because of the world of funny. Funny is the center of everything to me. So yes, it is above all.
They talk about your office in Encino and your own personal office. And how, unlike a lot of Hollywood offices, it is not lavish. There's not, you know, nobody's serving cut crystal glass and, fur rugs and that kind of stuff. You're nodding while I say that.
Why? I just didn't let you see it.
Why is it better to keep things...
I just didn't let you see that part.
Why is it better to keep things modest like that?
It just keeps you real, grounded, you know? I think that's a major key. You can have all the bells and whistles and they are nice, but I think keeping your surroundings in a real grounded place keeps you on a visual level of normalcy. I don't want to take that away from me or the people that are working around me. You know, we have one goal, and that goal is to achieve as much as we possibly can in the entertainment business, and we want to do it together. We want to do it as a team, as a unit, and to do it, we feel we need to motivate each other. The nice bells and whistles and crazy things aren't the things that are driving us and motivating us. What's really acting as motivation is getting a job done, projects, more projects, putting yourself on a list and putting goals on that list and checking them off. That's my motivation. That's my team's motivation. And thus far, we've done a good job of it.
No question about that. Kevin, enjoy your press tour this morning. We'll see you on the road and that new game show on CBS coming in a little bit.
That's why they took your office away.
All right,
you
LA, buckle up. I will be coming your way with my Raleigh Health Fest. I cannot wait. We're coming there August 18th. You guys be ready. I can't wait. Hollywood Bowl, I think he's saying, right?
Yeah, there it is.
That's a great venue.
But thanks, Kevin, so much. He's going to do Good Morning Secaucus or something. But it's, I mean, this Entrepreneur Magazine article is very interesting because the whole idea, you know, you wait for agents and everybody else to do this stuff. And he's like, no, you do it all yourself.
Yeah. You're like that.
No.
Come on.
Not as
we could all take a lesson.
All right.
Let's go over to Ginger. Yeah.